back to Piano Key A to G with your host, William Haviland. This week, episode 6, how to obtain free sheet music scores. Lovely to be back here on the podcast with you, and I hope you've had a fantastic week. Last week's show was quite a marathon. We were episode 5. We were talking about the history and anatomy of the piano, and this week's episode is going to be significantly shorter for a number of reasons. And the main reason you may have guessed is because I'm actually recording this on the Saturday before it goes live. Normally, I try to record earlier in the week, and this week it was just impossible to do that. So an opportunity to do a shorter show, but actually potentially very useful, because in the new year, one of the things I want to do with the podcast is just to sit down together with the individual scores, often maybe a classical score, or something in the public domain, and have a look at key features of the piece, the tempo, the dynamics, the mood, the directions from the composer, maybe features of harmony, of melody, and so on. And so I thought it would be a good idea to let you know that there is a wonderful project online where you can obtain an enormous library of free public domain sheet music. So the online resource I'm talking about is called the Petrucci Music Library. I'll spell that for you. P-E-T-R-U-C-C-I. Petrucci Music Library. I might be mispronouncing that. Apologies if so. And the website is imslp.org. It's probably worth to clarify that I have no affiliation to the project. It's something that I'd stumbled across in my younger days, and it's been very useful to me over the years. And the nice feature, if you just have a look, and I think there is some paid aspect, you can pay for some kind of subscription, but basically it is free to use, and you can search, for instance, I just typed in the Debussy Arabesque, so you can search by composer, by piece, and you're then going to find there might be audio MP3. You can actually have a listen to the piece, and then a collection of scores. And the nice thing is, often the scores can be very old editions, maybe even the original print of the composer. That's actually quite interesting. So it's just a wonderful resource, and I wanted to share it with you in case you were not aware of this availability. It's probably worth a mention as well. What exactly we mean by public domain? It's actually quite complicated in terms of music, so I won't go into detail. But in, let's say, anything that was composed prior to 1900, that's not quite the exact date, but it varies between territories. So for the sake of safety, anything before it's probably around 1910 now, and maybe the mid 1910s, but it varies enormously around the world. So for the sake of safety, anything before any Bach, any Mozart, any Schumann, that is going to be in the public domain, and it means that providing this project has had the time to upload, there will be resources available. So that's what we mean. It means that the copyright has expired on that particular work. So this will not include pop arrangements for Adele, for instance. Obviously, that is still very much in copyright. Now, just as a word of caution here, and probably self-protection, I should say that I'm a significant part of my living is made as a sheet music arranger. So, in case you don't know, I'm one of the signature artists for sheet music retailer musicnotes.com, and you can find me there if you type in my name, William Haviland. You'll find a collection of over 200 mostly pop covers that I've been making over the last few years. So this is not an attempt to stop you buying sheet music. Please, if you find arrangements that you like, please do buy them, because it keeps us going. I simply wanted to share this as a potential resource, because oftentimes we might be in the position where we're not able to buy a sheet music arrangement that's being sold, or the books. And it's lovely to have books, but in the event that you're not able to find one or to purchase one, I wanted to let you know of this resource. I should say, I came back to the UK not that long ago, and when I moved into my new accommodation, this might sound strange. I had to order everything to set up again. I needed a new digital piano, a computer, obviously things like a TV and a sofa. But when I was setting up my piano studio here, it was of course lovely to have the instrument and then some pieces of furniture in the room. I bought and assembled a cabinet so I could store some music related things, but the item that gave me the most pleasure when it arrived was my first collection of sheet music books, and sort of the start again of my music library. There is something you know, if you read novels, there is just something nice and tactile about having the physical book, not a piece of paper, but an actual sort of tome in front of you. And music book collections are the same. I think the first things I bought were, I think the collection of Chopin preludes. We've already talked briefly about one of the preludes in an earlier episode. I'm sure we will look at those more in the future. Also the Schumann album for the young, which if you don't know it, is a glorious collection of pieces written by Schumann for children, for early learners, and that really brought back memories for me of learning when I was a kid. And it was lovely to see to recognize the covers. It's a sort of a very bright orange cover on the Schumann. It just brought back memories, and it's nice having those items that you can work through. So, as I say, in the new year, we're going to be looking at we might be looking at a sonata, or it might just be a movement or a 16 bar section from something. So, of course, in the event that you have the actual book collection, and that will be great. There will be lots of editorial support there that can be useful, of course, do that if you're able. But in the event that you're not, this online resource means that if you want to, you can have a copy on the screen or download and print off so that it's in front of you. So you can sort of, if you read sheet music, you can work through it with me at the same time. I think that's a wrap for this week. I did say it was going to be shorter. Next week, we're going to do part one of two Christmas episodes, as it's coming up to Christmas. So please do tune in for next week's episode. We'll look at a favorite Christmas carol. That leads me just to mention the composer quotes. Last week, the quote was from Brahms. I'll repeat the quote. The idea comes to me from outside of me and is like a gift. I then take the idea and make it my own. That is where the skill lies. I chose that quotation because I think there's a lot of truth in that, in the sense that as somebody who is a composer myself, and I've never fully felt that I've crafted an idea. You have this sense that, you know, all sound is already pre-existing in nature, every pitch imaginable, and that what we're doing is kind of tuning into our database, our experience of sound, and then maybe like a potter, just fashioning those, fusing those together to make a new arrangement, a new design. But those sort of constituent parts, it might be just a pitch, it might be an interval, but that we are merely taking those and shaping them into something that has the appearance of originality. Quote for next week. We mentioned Schumann and his album for the young, so let's have Robert Schumann. To send light into the darkness of men's hearts, such is the duty of the artist. Have a great week. See you next time.